So we are starting today's class with yesterday's little bit of recapitulation. So yesterday we discussed about how to compare the numbers, right? How to compare two numbers, which one is greater and which one is smaller, correct? And also we studied how to compare two to three numbers and to arrange them ascending order and descending order. And how did we do these two things, comparing two numbers and comparing a group of numbers? Either checking their place values, right? Checking their number of digits. That is how many total number of digits particular number has. Children, let me check if anybody is waiting for us. No. Here, Rupanshi Tiwari. Done. I haven't told. Okay, so this was your recapitulation. Also, we did how to form numbers by given 2 to 3 digits, right? 3 digits or 4 digits. That is, for example, if 4 to 5 digits are given, like for example, 1, 2, 3 and 4 is given. So, how to form different numbers? And how did we do that? We did it by placing each number in different places so that its value changes in every number. Like for example, if 1 is there, 1 we placed it in the thousands place, then in the hundreds place, then in the tens place, then in the ones place, and that's how we got different numbers. Like if the number is 1 2 3 4, so in one place 1 is in thousand place, so 1 2 3 4, okay, then 2 1 3 4, then 3 2 3 2 1, something like this, and we made numbers. One thing we studied about it is not to repeat any number. Otherwise, what will happen? We can keep on repeating numbers as many times and then we will not get a proper answer and we are going to land into confusion. Okay, so we will repeat only and only the numbers when they are asked to repeat. Okay, we are going to get certain questions also to repeat the numbers and we will see how to do it. So we did till here and we did one question of try these, right? Question number 1, A part we did, and B I said will be your homework, right? So I'll read the question once again for you. Use the given digits without repetition, means we cannot repeat any number, and we have to make the greatest and smallest 4 digit number. So what is the question? 9741. So we have to make, you can check your homework, children, from here, and we are writing this in copy. So simply without repeating any number, we start, for the greatest number we start from the largest number from here, that is which one is the biggest, that is 9, then 7, then 4 and 1. And then how to read the number? Simple, put place values and read the number 9741, correct? And then writing the smallest number directly, you can write from here, starting with the smallest number. We know which is the smallest number now, 1479. Okay, read the number, put the place value to read the number 1479. Okay, so this is how we complete B part of question number 1 of try these. Children, since your answer is correct, so we go to the next sum, that is C. Greatest 4 digit and smallest 4 digit. So we check which is the greatest number over here. 4750. 7. After 7? 5. After 5? 4. After 4? 0. Okay. Now we go to the smallest 4 digit number. Smallest 4 digit number. That is, what is the smallest 4 digit number? Just opposite of it. Who's the smallest number? 0. Okay. Then 4, very correct. Then 5 and then 7. So this is our answer. Yes, according to the question, that is our answer. But we have to find out whether it is 4 digit or not. So 1, 2, 3, 4 digits, yes. Let's read the number. When we read the number, we see that this number is actually 457, which is a 3 digit number. It is not a 4 digit number. Oh, that means our question is wrong. Right? Answer is wrong. We have written a wrong answer. How? We have given 0 in the first. We have put 0 in the first place. Putting 0 in the first place, we have made this place as it doesn't have any value. Why? Because 0 is there. 0 doesn't have any value. Okay. So now, what has happened here? We have made a wrong number. So, to correct it, what to do, children? Very simple. We exchange this place with the next smallest number. And what is the next smallest number? The next smallest number is 4. So we write here 4057. Okay? And this is your answer. This is your answer. How is this your answer? 4057. 4 digit number? Yes, it is 4 digit number. Is it the smallest 4 digit number formed by them? Yes, it is the smallest 4 digit number formed by them because we have shifted 0 to the second place. If we shift 0 to the third place, then we are again doing it wrong. Okay, children, I hope it is clear. Now, I will unmute you and you will let me know that it is clear. One child is waiting. Let me put her in. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta, we are writing in the copy. Yes.
Ma'am, I have to do it in homework.
Very good if you have done it in homework. Very good if you have done it in homework. Now, children. Since two students joined just now, just for them, I am explaining this once again. We are making, this is just as we did A yesterday. Okay, the same thing, when we come to the smallest 4 digit number and when we see 0 is there. So, instead of putting 0 in the first place, we always put 0 in the second place. Or you can say we exchange 0 with the second smallest number. After 0, who is the second smallest number? 4 is the second smallest number. Okay, so instead of writing 0, 4, 5, 7, or if I only talk about 0 and 4, so instead of writing 0 and 4, we write 4, 0. That is, we exchange the places of 0 and 4, and the new digit, which the new number which is formed by exchanging the digits is 4057. So after that you can cut this with a pencil if you want. If you want this to be there only, there's no problem. You can do that also. Okay, so this completes your C part. Now we go to the D part, children. And the D part is, let me write the question. Very simple, greatest 4 digit. So whichever is the greatest, largest here, we are going to write that. That is 7 after 7, 6 after 6, 2 after 2, 1. Okay, if you want, you can put the places and you can read the number. Okay, very simple, 7,621. Now, smallest 4 digit number just opposite. 1, 2, 6, 7. Are we correct? Yes, we are correct. We started with the smallest number which was present over here. Do we have to exchange the places? No. Why? Because it's not a 0. We do this only with 0. Okay. So, you don't have to exchange 1 and 2 and make it 2 and 1. Okay. Now, again, I will unmute you, children, and you will let me know whether you understood or not. Somebody is waiting. Let me put her in. Yes, you can unmute yourselves.
Yes, ma'am.
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 Clear. Very good. Very good. Okay. Now let's do the next one then. Okay. Okay. If it is clear, then next. Let's do the next one. Next, I was saying. Let's do the next one then. That is the E part. So very simple. Starting for the greatest, we are starting with the greatest number. So who's the greatest here? 5. After 5, 4. After 4, 3. After 3, 0. Okay, now going to the next smallest number. Starting with the smallest number, 0, 3, 4, 5. Are we correct? No, something wrong we have done. What is it? 0 and 3. Right? They are in the wrong places. Why? Because 0 in the first place doesn't have any value. So the answer becomes a 3-digit number, which is wrong. So instead of writing 0, 3, 4, 5, what we write? We write 3, 0, 4, 5. Okay? So now you will let me know whether your answer is correct or not. I will unmute you. You will let me know. Yes, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Very good. It is E, huh? It is not C. I have written here. Yes. Huh, very good if you have understood. This is E. Very good, children. Now we go to the next question. Yes. Let's go to the next question now. What is the next question? Question number 2. Question number 2 says, now make the greatest and smallest 4-digit numbers by using any 1-digit toys. Okay, so suppose, let's understand, try to understand. Suppose if you have these 3 numbers and you have to make the greatest 4-digit number and the smallest 4-digit number. Okay, so you have only 3 numbers. But you need 4 places. It means you will have to repeat any number. And that's what the question is saying. We have to repeat any number. Okay. So, for making the greatest 4-digit number, children, it will be very good if we repeat the greatest number. And for making the smallest number, we will repeat the smallest digit from the given digits. Okay, so let's start. Greatest 4-digit number. So to make greatest 4-digit number, what did we say? We said that we will repeat this number, the greatest number, 2 times. Okay, as it is written twice. Twice means 2 times. So we repeat 3 2 times. After that, what is the greatest number after 3? 2. After 2, what is left? 1. So this is the number, that is 3321. Now going to the smallest number. Now what did we say? We said that we are going to repeat the smallest number 2 times. Smallest number 2 times. 1, 1. After that, who's the next smallest number? 2. After 2, 3. So what is your answer? 1123. Okay. Now children, I will unmute you and you will let me know whether you understood this or not. If anybody has any doubt, can ask. Yes, children. No, no, beta, you don't have to write this in the copy. We will not write this in the copy. This is just explanation. No, no, it is just an example. You don't have to write in the copy. So, we are not writing this in the copy, children. This is just an example. I gave you one example to explain how to do it. Okay, now we will start in the copy. So let's write the question. Let's write the question in the short form. We have to make greatest and smallest 4-digit number. So here also we will write greatest 4-digit. Smallest 4-digit. Okay, let's see. So what did we discuss? We discussed that when we have to repeat any number, it will be very good. While making the greatest 4-digit number, we repeat the greatest number here. So, which is the greatest number here? 8. And while making the smallest 4-digit number, we are going to repeat the smallest number here. So, which is the smallest number here? 3. Okay, so let's start. 8, 8, 7, 3. Children, if you get confused here, then you make lines like this, okay? Make 4 blanks so that you will know that you have to fill 4 blanks, correct? Now, we have to make the smallest 4-digit number. For that, we will repeat this number 2 times. This number means which number out of the given numbers, the smallest number. So, 3, 3, 7, 8. This is clear, children? Wait, I'll unmute you. You will let me know. Okay, children. Very good. It is easy. Good. It is. If it is easy, very good. I am happy to hear that it's easy. Good if you've understood. Very good. Very good if it is easy. I'm happy to hear that. Let's do the B1 then. Okay, let's start. Again, we have to make a 4-digit number. For greatest 4-digit number, we are going to repeat 2 times the number which is the greatest here. And who is the greatest here? 9. And for making the smallest 4-digit number, we are going to repeat a number which is smallest over here. And which is the smallest number here in the question? 0. Okay, so now let's start. For greatest 4-digit number, 9, 9, 5, 0. Correct? And here for 4 digits, 0, 0, 5, 9. Are we correct? Yes, we are correct. But this is not the smallest 4-digit number. 0, 0 will have no value. So this is actually only 59, which is a 2-digit number. That means again we have made a mistake. Now what is that mistake? The mistake is putting 0 in the first place. So what to do? We have studied in our last question only. Whenever 0 is the smallest number, we exchange it with the second smallest number. Now which is the second smallest number here? 5. Right? So we exchange this 0 with this 5. So the number becomes 5009. Okay, children? So this is your answer. I'm unmuting you. Yes, children. Very good. If it is easy and it is clear, start C1. Okay. If it is easy, then start C1. You will tell me the answer for the C1. By the time I take your attendance, you do both the sums. I have taken your attendance. So, as we discussed, that for the greatest 4-digit number, the greatest number is repeated, right? So, here who will be repeated? 9 will be repeated. 9, 9, 4, 0. And here, 4-digit number, smallest 4-digit number, who will be repeated? 0, 0, 4, 9. But again, this is wrong. Why? Because we have written 0 in the first place. Where 0 in the first place doesn't have any value. So what to do, children? We exchange its place with the second smallest number, which is 4. So actually the answer is 4009. That is 4009. Now come on, you will tell me the answer for D. I will unmute you. You will let me know the answer. Okay, Samriddhi has sent the message also. Very good. Your answer is correct. Yes, D1. Yes, 8,851. Yes, correct. Match your answers. Correct. All are correct. Very good. It was easy. Very good. Very, very good if it was easy. So this completes the question number 2. Let's start question number 3. Make the greatest and smallest numbers using any 4 digits with conditions as given. Let me write the question first. So we have to make again four digit number, right? Yes, 4 digit number we have to make, that is greatest and smallest. And there are conditions also. Okay, there are conditions also. The first one is already done for us. Let's check whether it is correct or not. The question says digit 7 is always in ones place. 7 is at ones place. Children, we are doing this in book. Okay? If you have started in copy, no problem. You can do in copy also. Who have not started can do it in book also because there is place. Now, we know that what are the numbers? What are the numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are the numbers. The entire number system lives in these numbers, that is 0 to 9. Correct? Now, we need to make greatest and smallest numbers. So, obviously, we'll use these numbers only. Okay? But there is a condition. What is that condition? That 7 has to be at ones place. That means, be it a greatest number, be it a smallest number, 7 will come at ones place. Okay? So, let's form the greatest number first. So, for forming the greatest number, what is the greatest number from here? 0 to 9. 9. After 9, what is the next number? 8. After 8, what is the next number? 7. But we cannot write 7 here. Why? Because it is not asked to repeat twice or thrice or any time. Correct. So you cannot use 7. Why? Because 7 is already written. So what is the next number you should use? 6. So this is your answer for the greatest 4 digit number with condition 7 at once. Now making the smallest number. For making the smallest number, children, what are the smallest numbers which we can use? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So let's start. So which one we will write here? The smallest number? 0. But we have already studied that 0 in the first place doesn't have any value. So what to do? 0 goes to the second place. What is the second place? This is the second place. Now, after 0, what is the next number which is considered as smallest? 1. So, we write 1 here. After 1, which number? 2. We cannot write 2 here. So, where to write 2? Third place. Okay. The fourth place is already taken by 7 as per condition. Okay. So, which is your answer, children? This is your answer. And how to get the answer? We have done it. Okay. So, now again, I will unmute you and you will let me know whether you understood or not.
Yes, ma'am, it was very easy. That was very easy. I have just done my question.
Very good.
Ma'am, even I finished this full exercise.
Okay, very good. Okay. Good if it is easy. Very good. Okay. Then we will do the B part now. Let's do the B part. Let's see what is the condition in B. Digit 4 has to be at tens. Digit 4 has to be at tens. Greatest, smallest. Let's start. Which is the tens place, children? Which is the tens place? 0, 1s, tens, hundreds, thousands. Which is the tens place? Second place is the tens place. So write here 4. Okay. Now get back to the number system. For making the greatest digits, what we are going to write first? 9. After 9, 8. After 8, 7. But this place has been taken by 4. And we cannot change this place because it is already said that the condition you have to use is 4 at tens. So where to write 7? Here. Okay. So this is your greatest number when 4 is at tens. Similarly, we make the smallest number. What is the smallest number? Get back again. What is the smallest number? 0. Can you write 0 in the first place? No. We have discussed so many times today that we cannot write 0 in the first place, as 0 in the first place has no value. So what to write? We write 0 in the second place. We write 0 in the second place. Now 0 gone to the second place. Now what is the next number after 0? Who is considered smallest? 1. So we write 1 here. After that, what is the next number? 2. Where to write 2? This place is not empty. We jump to the next place. So the answer is 1042, or you can say 1042. Now you will let me know whether you understood or not. The greatest and the smallest. This is your C. You will tell me the answer. D condition also I am writing. 1 is in thousands place. This is the thousand place and this is the hundreds place. Okay? If we get confused, what to do? We write the places. Children, in 10 seconds, meeting will get over. So you can leave the meeting. I have taken the attendance. Okay. It's better you, we will continue this tomorrow. Or you can do as homework. Okay, do as homework.